Hi everyone, this recording is a quick introduction to Globalyzer. Globalyzer helps you analyze, perform, manage, and track internationalization so you're ready for localization. Globalyzer will look for embedded strings, images, static files. It'll look for locale and safe functions, methods, classes, all depending upon the programming languages. Those are programmatic elements that maybe only say a date time in a particular, say, US-centric format, or will deprecate character encoding, as well as programming patterns that may be unique to your software application. Globalyzer is optimized for internationalization of complex architectures, sites, and, for instance, software as a service applications. It's developed to support entire teams. We use it here at Lingoport for many of our services projects as well. Globalyzer has a number of parts to it. First, there's the server. Then the client, there are two versions of clients. One is a desktop application that really lets you configure and set up and navigate through your code. Another is a command line tool. We'll talk about each of them in a little bit more detail, and you'll also see additional webinars on our site going into them in further detail. First of all, let's take a look at the Globalyzer server. Now, I'm all logged in here, and this is the home screen, and from there I can look at my rule sets as well as other people on my team, my development team. I can look at their rule sets as well. Now, what a rule set is simply the way that I've configured Globalyzer to run on a specific application. We'll look at a rule set I've created to go over some Java source code today here, and you'll see that there's detection rules, and there's filtering rules, and there's also exception rules. So what that means is these are all the ways that Globalyzer will look for internationalization issues, and you see the major categories of locale-sensitive methods, static file references, and general patterns, as well as filter rules. That's stuff that you don't want to see, and there are categories of filters for each sort of issue, from strings to methods to static files and general patterns. All that works in conjunction with the Globalyzer client. And this is a quick view. The Globalyzer client runs on your local machine, and that's important because you're not submitting your source code to a website. Everything that touches your source code is run on the Globalyzer client on your local machine. So on the Globalyzer client, you can see several windows here. This is a list of specific issues. Here's your source tree. Here is a summary report summarizing what's been found. And you can see in this case, I'm looking at some Java source code. It's an open source project called TaskBlocks. And on here, I'm looking for embedded strings. And you can see I can get directly to that embedded string from the issue view to the source view. And from there, I can do things such as externalize strings. I can externalize strings in batch once I've looked at them. I can look at these unsafe methods to make sure that the context that they're using them is really an issue. I can refactor it right there. I can tag things for later review, and a whole batch of issues here, and then which are controlled by the status markings within Globalyzer. I can also go back to the server, fine-tune my search using this button, and I can generate reports that can be output to, let's say, Excel or text files, whatever it is you like, and distributed amongst your teams. Finally, I want to go back here to explain the command line. And command line you use to set up using the Globalyzer graphical user interface here. Once you have that set up, you can load up your projects and run command line as part of, say, an automated process like a build. And that will generate reports that you can then automatically send out to various team members and monitor your progress. Now, remember, you might wonder, well, what's so different about Globalyzer than doing the traditional methods of internationalizing large applications? And you have to remember, the traditional way is to kind of hunt and peck through various presentation layers of your application. But remember, your complex software is chances are not just presenting data, but taking it in, transforming it in some way, managing it within in and out of a database, and then bringing it out again. And it's very hard to find all those issues that affect localization later on and a truly internationalized product. So the Globalyzer way looks at your files as static text files, goes through them, and finds those issues before testing. It gives you a reduced time to market instead of, let's say, writing a grep, having to hunt and peck through that grep, and then looking at individual issues, pour through those through your web pages for specific strings, methods, etc., and then one by one going through those issues and reviewing them. Globalyzer lets you see a lot of those things in a batch mode. Then finally, you have a heavy emphasis here on testing and then doing it again and doing it again. With Globalyzer, you're really looking to eliminate many of those testing cycles. So again, with Globalyzer, this is basic principle of software development. The earlier you find your coding issues, the less expensive in time and money it is to go ahead and fix them. So again, in Globalyzer, we're looking to find those internationalization issues way down here, so that during testing, we're really executing over many locales and we're supporting our worldwide users right away, rather than finding those issues in localization where it's hard to kick them back and then you've already gone through bug fixing cycles and it's much more expensive to fix them at that later time. If you have further questions regarding Globalyzer or Lingoport and our internationalization services, you can find us at any one of these contact points over here or just give us a call. I also welcome you to try Globalyzer. It's free to set up a trial account. That trial account has quite a bit of capability. And visit lingoport.com/globalyzer to learn more. You'll also find quite a number of resource pages, white papers, and articles within lingoport.com to support you in your efforts. Thank you.